Hello friends, welcome to my channel. I am Dr. Himanshu Gupta and in this video I am going to discuss one important topic, that is joints. So the most important question that comes in this topic is, what type of joint is this particular joint? What type of joint is elbow joint? Talocalcaneonavicular joint is a type of joint between malleus and incus is a type of which joint? So let us begin our discussion on the topic of joints. So joints are first classified as structural or functional classification, structural and functional classification. On the basis of functional classification, we have immovable joints, slightly movable joints, and freely movable joints. Okay. Immovable joints, the examples are fibrous joints and primary cartilaginous joint. So we will discuss what are the examples of primary cartilaginous joints. The slightly movable joints, they are also called as amphiarthrosis. There is only some degree of mobility in slightly movable joints, that is amphiarthrosis, and the example is secondary cartilaginous joint. Okay, now coming to freely movable joints. The freely movable joints are synovial joints, and they are also known as diarthrosis. So we will again discuss, immovable joints are known as synarthrosis, slightly movable joints are known as amphiarthrosis, and freely movable joints are known as diarthrosis. So coming to the structural classification, based on the structure, the joints are classified as fibrous, cartilaginous, and synovial joints. So coming to the fibrous joints, in fibrous joints we have three types of classification. These are sutures, syndesmosis, and gomphosis. In sutures, it is further classified as plain, serrated, and chindalysis. The example are internasal suture. In serrated, the example are sagittal suture. And in chindalysis is a joint in which a ridge of one bone fits into the groove of the other one. The example is joint between warmer and sphenoid bone. Other types of sutures that are found are denticulate suture. It is seen in, the example is lambdoid suture, the suture between the parietal bone and the occipital bone. The examples are radio ulnar joint and tibio fibular joint. These joints are the joints where two bones are linked by considerably greater amount of connective tissue. Example is radio ulnar joint and tibio fibular joints. What is gomphosis? Gomphosis are the joints which are found in the alveolar sockets of mandible and maxilla. Okay, revising again, the fibrous joints are of three types: sutures, syndesmosis, and gomphosis, and we have discussed the examples. So coming to cartilaginous joints, these are further of two types: primary cartilaginous joints and secondary cartilaginous joints. Primary cartilaginous joints are temporary and they are immovable. These joints are united by a plate of hyaline cartilage, which is converted to bone as the development occurs after completion of growth. Okay, So these joints are also known as synostosis. Synostosis. So examples are the joint between the basisphenoid and basiocciput. First, costosternal joint, costochondral joints, and the joint between the epiphysis and diaphysis of long bone. Remember that first costosternal joint is a primary cartilaginous joint. Rest of the joints are plain synovial joints. Coming to secondary cartilaginous joints, these joints are covered by a thin layer of hyaline cartilage and united by a disc of fibrocartilage. Examples are symphysis pubis, sacrococcygeal joint, manubriosternal joint, the joint between the intervertebral discs, and symphysis menti. Okay, the movement between the joints is less and permitted due to the compressible pad of fibrocartilage. So coming to synovial joints, these joints possess a cavity and the articular surface is surrounded by fibrous capsule. So you have to remember the articular surface is covered by articular cartilage, and this articular cartilage is made up of hyaline cartilage, except you have to know the exceptions where this articular cartilage is not made of hyaline cartilage. The examples are temporomandibular joint, sternoclavicular joint, and acromioclavicular joint, AC joint. In these joints, the articular cartilage is made up of fibrocartilage. So coming to plain synovial joints, the examples are intercarpal joints and intertarsal joints. Hinge joints, as you know, they permit movement only in one plane. The example is elbow joint, and interphalangeal joint. Okay, pivot joints, the atlanto-axial joint. It permits movement in two planes. Okay, so this is the movement on atlanto-axial joint. Okay. Now coming to condylar joint, the example is knee joint and TMJ joint is a type of condylar joint. Coming to ellipsoid joints, the joints between the metacarpal and phalanges is a ellipsoid joint, and the joint in the wrist is a ellipsoid joint. Coming to saddle joints. So saddle joints, the examples are first carpometacarpal joint, sternoclavicular joint is one joint which we do not think of as saddle joint. So do remember this, sternoclavicular joint is a type of saddle joint. Calcaneocuboid joint, incudiomalleolar joint, and patellofemoral joint. So to remember the joint between the malleus and incus, the mnemonic is MIS. Malleus and incus, the joint is saddle joint, miss. Coming to ball and socket joint, the joints are, you know, hip joint, shoulder joint, talocalcaneonavicular joint. It is an important joint that you have to remember, that is a ball and socket joint, talocalcaneonavicular joint. Okay, and the last joint that is ball and socket is the joint between the incus and stapedius is a ball and socket joint. The joint between the malleus and incus is a saddle joint, and the joint between incus and stapedius is a ball and socket joints. So friends, I will be coming up with more videos like this. If you like my video, do share it among your friends and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you, friends.